Here's one way you can unlock your potential using Asana. Transform your business with this easy-to-use, easy-to-implement SOP Bank right within Asana. Why have it any other place when you're already using Asana, right? I'm big on having as many things as possible in one place, so that's why I love to keep my SOPs right within Asana, along with all the other things in my business. So keep watching, and I will show you exactly how I store all of my SOPs within Asana. Hi, my name is Samantha. If you are new here, welcome, welcome. I am so happy to have you, and I hope this video gives you everything that you're looking for and is super helpful for you. And if you're already a subscriber, thank you for subscribing. It means the world to me that you support me, and I just hope that I am giving you as much value as you are looking for from me. And yeah, I just can't wait to keep seeing you every week. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. I am an online business manager. I help my clients manage and run the back ends of their businesses. And I also help all service providers set up their organizational systems, their central business hubs, right within Asana to make everything streamlined and flow seamlessly and just clear up all that mental space. As you know, if you are looking for ways to store your SOPs, which I assume you are since you clicked on this video, you know how important SOPs are to any online business. I mean, any business, not just online businesses. SOPs are how we manage, how we delegate all the processes in our business so that everyone knows exactly what to do to complete the process. But basically, they are so important for every business owner to have stored and to regularly audit as well. Asana makes this super easy because you can assign yourself the task right within the SOP in order to remember to audit it every so often. I recommend every quarter. So even if you don't have a team yet, I highly recommend that you start setting up SOPs in your business if you haven't already, because then it's already there and it makes it super easy for you to start delegating when you do hire that first team member. It's a complete game changer. It'll take so much less stress and much less time, much less mental energy when you do go to hire that first team member. Okay, so first you are going to want to create a new project. Click blank project, title it SOP Bank, keep it in the list view, and continue. Go to project. And then in here, you're going to want to add any sections for organization, so the main categories in your business. So for this, the purposes of this one that I'm going to show you is going to be marketing. And then for this example SOP that I'm going to give you, it's going to be how to schedule YouTube Shorts. So I'm going to show you an example template that I use for my SOPs as well. So this is how I create the actual SOPs within the SOP bank. I'll just give you a quick overview of how I do it to give you an idea how your SOPs that you're storing can look right within Asana. So you're going to click into the task and then click into the description. And then I am just going to copy and paste this part. So this top part is going to just give the overview of the task, the needed information in order for someone who is brand new coming in to know exactly what's going on. So main owner and relevant players is going to be the person or people who are going to be typically completing this process. I like to put the title of the position instead of the name. So if you were to add a new team member to your team, this is a big time saver just putting in the position. So this one is going to involve the CEO and the virtual assistant. So we will put them both there. And then this description or purpose part just gives some context to the task for someone brand new coming in, gives them a bit of information about the process. Sorry, I said task, but the process. So for this one, we can just say short clips are created from full YouTube videos to post as YouTube Shorts following the full video. So that just gives a bit of context of what this process is all about and what we are doing within it. So assets needed would be Asana and YouTube. And then I like to keep it very simple up here. I know it is typical in SOPs to provide a whole lot of information up here, like when it was created, when it was last updated, who created it, those kind of things. However, one of the reasons I love using Asana, this saves you time when creating your SOPs, is that information is all down here. So you can see I created this task and I created it May 10th at 10:17 a.m. You can see that I added it to the SOP bank. As you update the description, if I come in here tomorrow and update the description, it will show that
down here as well as an update, and you can click to see previous versions as well. So it's not necessary to have all that added information up here because Asana creates that for you, which I just love so much. And that's why it's so much easier to keep it within Asana. That's one of the reasons that it's easier to keep it within Asana. Okay, so the next part that I like to do is I do a section for video instructions. I will make this a heading, and then underneath it, I will add the video instructions. So you can just put it right in here. If you're using Loom, which I highly recommend, it will show up as a preview here. Someone can come in and just watch it right within Asana, or they can watch it right within Loom if they would prefer. This is another amazing reason to use the Asana SOP, because you can just have this right within here. You don't even have to leave Asana to watch the video. The next part that is essential for an SOP is to have all the steps laid out and written. Now, you don't necessarily have to do this right away because it is a bit time consuming. You can just start with a video that is helpful to your assistant, but because different people learn in different ways, it's really important to have these different ways of telling someone what to do, and it saves them from having to rewatch the entire video just to find that one step. So while a video can be very helpful in showing exactly what to do, the steps are equally helpful if someone is just quickly looking at which steps they need to complete. So for this one, it's a bit complex because there's two people actually working on it. So I have it separated to the CEO tasks, which happen first, and then the VA tasks, which happen after these tasks. So you want to be as detailed as possible when you're creating these steps. Say exactly what to do in clear and concise language. And something that's actually really amazing is I didn't even write this. I had ChatGPT write this from the transcript, and then I just went in and edited it as necessary, took out some things that didn't make sense and added some things in where it applied. But that makes it way less time consuming. If you want a video on how to do that, let me know and I will provide that for you. So the next part that I include in my SOPs is this little blurb down here, just saying that SOPs should be audited for revisions once per quarter after completion. This will be indicated by the subtask due date on completed SOPs. So this SOP is completed. So underneath here, I would add a subtask saying audit SOP for revisions, and then I would assign it to either the CEO or the VA, probably the VA in this case, the person who is the owner of it, the relevant player, the person who is completing this process on a regular basis. So we will just assign it to Lucy. Then I would set it up for 3 months from now and set it up to recur every 3 months on the 10th day, so that she can go in and say, oh yeah, so this part of the process changed, and just make those revisions. We can also use this as an opportunity to look for places to streamline things more, to cut tasks that aren't necessary, and just make it a better, more streamlined process if that applies. So that's the actual SOP that I set up in there. Hopefully that's helpful for you. With the SOP bank, you are going to want to create sections, as I said, for each category in your business, and then add the applicable tasks underneath that. I would also recommend adding the field for tags. This just adds a little extra to it, and you can easily see I like to add tags for completed, and then I just added these two as examples. We can add a task for incomplete, so if this is one has been started but it's not yet completed, we can note that here. And then for the ones we know we need to do but we have not yet started, we can add that as a tag here, and then you can easily see that in here. So when you know that task comes up in Asana that you need to work on your SOPs or revise your SOPs, then you can come in here and easily see which ones you need to work on first and which ones need to be completed.
So I hope that this helps you so much. I hope that it helps having it right within Asana, right where you have all the other things in your business. If you're like me, then you have everything, every little tiny thing in Asana. I hope that that was super helpful for you. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions at all about this or anything else you would love to see me do in Asana. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you liked this video. And if you want to see more of the videos, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell too so that you never miss another video. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next week. Bye.